Hello, welcome to GYAS. How are you? I hope you are doing well. So friends, as you know that on our channel, we are covering the syllabus of UPSC Civil Services. And for this purpose, we have started MCQ series of different topics like Ancient India, Medieval India, Modern India, etc. So what we are doing in these series, basically we cover daily 5 questions of each topic. So currently we have 6 prelims oriented series in which we cover 5 questions of each topic. So total we cover daily 30 questions of each of different topics. So we will continue to do so till 31st May. And why the date chosen has been 31st May? Because on 2nd June is your prelims of UPSC, and we will end this series only one day before your prelims exam. So if you see the MCQ series of Modern India, so today we are doing its lecture number 18. So already we have covered 17 lectures of this. So already you can 17 multiplied by 3, it amounts to 85. So already we have covered 85 questions of Modern India only, and we will continue to do so to cover these series till 31st May. So if you go by calculation, then approximately 1000 questions of each topic will be covered by us in these series of different subjects which we have picked up for coverage on daily basis. So you can imagine that how much practice you will be doing before your prelims exam if you follow this series daily. So that much amount of practice is obviously needed so as to get an edge over other students in your exam. So if you want to be confident in your prelims exam and want to clear it with great margin, then do follow these series regularly. So let's start a discussion of today's lecture of Modern India. The first question is, A.O. Hume, a retired British civil servant, was accepted as the chief organizer of Indian National Congress by the leaders of that time. What is the most appropriate reason for this? So A is to utilize the administrative knowledge of A.O. Hume. B is the Indian leaders had little organizational experience. C is to avoid the official hostility at this early stage. D is differences of opinion among the Indian leaders. Friends, let me tell you that the correct option is C, that is to avoid the official hostility at the early stage. That is, solution is C. Because why, friends? Because at that time the political politicization of Indian people was not much. They were not politically educated, and obviously they were not in a stage to lead a protest against the government. And they were only few people who had the political understanding of that time. So these leaders decided to have an organization which could put the interest of India before the British. So as to pressurize the British government to bring in reforms for the administration of India. So at that time they thought that it would be better if they integrate a British civil servant into this organization, because it would avoid the hostility of the British Empire, which could even lead to suppression of their organization, that is Indian National Congress. So that's why they appointed accepted A.O. Hume as the chief organizer of Indian National Congress. So already I have explained to you in detail. So here is more explanation. That is, A.O. Hume was a man of high ideals and with whom Indian leaders did not find dishonor to cooperate. So there were, the main reason was basically like in the conditions of time. So there were very few political persons and they did not wanted the opposition of the rulers to their organization. So they thought that the cooperation with an Englishman would obviously be better, because it would avoid the official hostility. So that was the reason. So let's move on to the second question. The second question is, which of the following acts made provisions to grant permission to the Christian missionaries for the propagation of religion in India? So here we have been asked that in which act the Christian missionaries were allowed to propagate their religion in India. So the options are Pitt's India Act of 1784, the B is Charter Act of 1813, C is Charter Act of 1833, the D option is Charter Act of 1853. So let's tell me, you friends, that the answer to this question is B, that is Charter Act of 1813. So in this act, basically the Christian missionaries were kind of given the permission to propagate their religion in India. So there were other things also that were done in this Charter Act, like ending of the monopoly of East India Company in trade with India, and accept trade in tea and trade with China. So there were also other things like education and education field in different fields that were introduced. So the solution is B. So the explanation of this question is provided in the explanation. We provide only you people the explanation of only first question. And if you want to get the explanation of all the questions, then you will have to subscribe to these daily initiatives. So what is the procedure for subscription? I will let you know later. But let's move on to the third question. The third question is with reference to Heather Ali. Consider the following statements. First is, he introduced new system of coinage and new scales of weights and measures in Mysore. Second statement is, he established a modern arsenal at Dindigul with the help of French experts. So let me tell you, friends, that the correct option is B, that is second only, because first statement is wrong. Actually, in actual practice, the coinage system, the new coins and new standards of weights and measures were introduced by his son Tipu Sultan, but not the Hyder Ali. So but the second statement is correct, that he established a modern arsenal at Dindigul with the help of French experts. So the correct option is B. So the solution is B, and the explanation is in explanation PDFs, which you people can subscribe to. So let's move on to fourth question. With reference to the land revenue policy of British, which of the following statements is correct? First is, land revenue policies made land all over country saleable and mortgageable. Second, land revenue was periodically revised in Rathwadi areas but was fixed in permanent settlement and Mahalwadi settlement. Third is, areas covered by Mahalwadi system included northwestern provinces, parts of Punjab and districts of Banaras. So let me tell you, friends, that the correct option is B, that is 1 and 3 only. Because why, friends, this is correct? Because let me tell you that the first statement is correct and the third is correct and not the second. Why second is not correct? Here it is said that land revenue was periodically revised in Rathwadi areas, but let me tell you, friends, that that this was fixed in only permanent settlement. In Mahalwadi system also, the land revenue was periodically revised, but here it is saying that the land revenue was fixed also in Mahalwadi settlement, but this is not the case. So that's why second statement is incorrect, but the first is correct, that the land was made saleable and mortgageable, and also in areas that were covered by Mahalwadi settlement, included northwestern provinces, parts of Punjab and districts of Banaras. So friends, let me correct myself. The third statement is also incorrect, because in third statement here we are saying that the districts of Banaras were covered under the Mahalwadi settlement, but let me tell you that districts of Banaras were not covered under this. So districts only that were covered, this districts of Banaras, they came under the under the permanent settlement and not the Mahalwadi settlement. Actually, Mahalwadi settlement of system of land revenue covered the areas like northwestern provinces, parts of Punjab and central provinces, and the districts of Banaras, they were under the permanent settlement. So Bengal, Bihar, Odisha and some districts of Banaras, they were under the permanent settlement. So this is the correct option. So only one statement is correct. So only land revenue policies made land all over the country saleable and mortgageable. So the option correct is A, that is one only. So for by mistake here it is mentioned 9. So it is not 9, it is 1 only. So the correct option is A. So second is also wrong, third is also wrong, because land revenue was periodically revised in Rathwadi and Mahalwadi both. So let's move on to the fifth question. The fifth question is, with reference to Hunter Commission 1882-83, consider the following statements. statements are, it was appointed to inquire into the state of elementary education throughout the Indian Empire. Second is, it was appointed to inquire into the general functioning of Indian universities. Third is, it proposed separate divisions for literary and vocational education. So which of the following statements is correct? So we have to choose the correct statement. So here we have been asked to choose the correct statement regarding the Hunter Commission. So let me tell you, friends, that the first statement is correct, that yes, it was appointed in to inquire into the state of to inquire into the state of elementary education over the British India. And about third statement is also correct, that it suggested separate divisions for literary and vocational education. Regarding the second statement, friends, the second statement was incorrect. Second statement is incorrect because it had no role to play with the Indian universities, that with the Indian universities. So the correct option is one and third only, that is the B option. So the solution is B. So this is all about, friends, today's lecture. If you liked it, please like it, share it with your friends. And let me tell you, friends, that why we are not providing the explanation PDFs to you people, and why it is important for you people to get the explanation PDFs, because at the end of the day, friends, you will not be able to read the bulky books that are like NCERTs or the standard books, and also you will not be able to see the long videos that are 15 to 20 minute long, because at that time you will not have that much of that much of time. Also, it becomes boring for you people to revise the same things, to read the same books again and again. At the most, you can read standard books and NCERTs for the two time. So at that time, you must have some other structure by the way of which you can do your revision. So the most appropriate and the most followed approach is of question answer format, in which what you do, would you just pick up question and what you attempt them. When you do the question, you go for its answer. If you find your answer wrong, then you go for its explanation, and in this way you get the idea, and in this way you are able to revise your whole syllabus multiple times. Also, friends, UPSC is not just about seeing a question and its solution. It is much more than that, because in it we have to see the explanation of the question also, because it is not just that you see a question and its solution and you cram it and then you will be able to sail through the UPSC, because UPSC is about concepts, clearing your concepts as well as keeping in mind the facts. So these things can take place only if you follow this approach of question and answer and its explanation. So explanation is a much needed part of your preparation, because it helps you in revision, which becomes boring in case of standard books, by doing through standard books. So if you want to get these explanation PDFs, you can WhatsApp us at a given number. This is a number that is provided here. So 8968426481. So this is our WhatsApp number. So if you want to subscribe to them, let me tell you, friends, we have kept a minimum subscription fee for all these initiatives that we are running on our YouTube, that is Environment, Ancient India, Medieval India, Modern Geography and Polity. So friends, to get the PDFs of these MCQs, you will have to make a single time payment. So this is not a, for example, take the case of Environment. So for the Environment, for the entire series of Environment, you have to pay just rupees 50. That is, as we are already on the lecture number 47, so you will get in these rupees 50 the MCQs of previous lectures that we have covered, and also the forthcoming lectures that we will be covering till 31st May. So you have to make a single time payment of rupees 50. So it is not the cost of one PDF. So it is the cost of entire course of Environment. And similarly, for Ancient India, we have kept the minimum fee 100, and Medieval India also the cost is 100, Modern India also 100. And similarly, geography as we are covering four angles, so that's why cost is quite higher for it, that is 400, and for Polity it is 200. So if you total these, then the total amounts to 950. But if you want to subscribe to them in a package format, then we are offering you a discount of rupees 150. That is, you can get this complete package in rupees 800. And if you want to subscribe to these explanation PDFs, you can WhatsApp us at this given number, that is 8968426481. So this is our number. So you can you can WhatsApp us at this number and you can subscribe to these initiatives. So this is all about friends today's video. If you liked it, please like it, share it with your friends, and please subscribe to our channel, and please do not forget to press the bell icon, because then only you will get all the important notifications of the updates that we do on YouTube. So thank you friends, thank you very much.